In this video, we'll show you how we can machine the outside shape and also the fillet radius along the top of this shape. So this is the solid model we're working on, and we can see that the datum position is where I want it to be, which is the bottom left-hand corner, and the with the Z at the maximum, which is the height of the component. So when we're dealing with solid models, we need to create sketches, which will be the shape that we can machine. So if I use the center mouse wheel and then right click and choose the parameters I want, which in this case is pick faces. So if I pick that face and then right click, I can make a sketch from that face. So now a sketch item has been put into the objects tree here, so I can now use that sketch to create a machining operation. So we go into the milling module and we'll define a tool, and let's say for instance we want an end mill of 12 millimeters diameter, and the cutting edge height, this component is around about 25 mil deep, so we want the cutting edge obviously to be more than that. So that's the tool there. It always shows us the tool when we select a tool so that we can see it, but if you don't want to see that, you just click on something else. So that's the tool that we're going to use. So we've got a sketch there, so we can now do a profiling operation on that. So there's two ways we can do this. We can either choose from the toolbar here, or if I right click, I can say a new profile operation based on that sketch. So we want to cut on the outside of the sketch. We can either climb or conventional mill. The roll radius is the approach and runoff. If we need to leave an extra offset, then we can do that here. Going down here, we choose the tool that we want. We've only got one tool, so that's it. I'm not interested in any surfaces at the moment, but in subsequent machining operations, I'll show you how that works. The clearance plane is measured as an absolute distance from Z0. So in my case, Z0 is the top of the job, so my clearance plane is somewhere above that, where it's clear of any fixtures or fixings, where it can wrap it between one position and next. The feed change plane is a distance above Z0, where it'll change from a rapid to a feed rate. The work surface, which is the top of the job, is at Z0. And my final depth is the depth I want to cut, and that's minus 25. If I want to use a step down, I put that in here. I'll click OK. So that has now calculated that toolpath. If we need to go back and modify that toolpath, we simply double click the entry and we can change the step down, the final depth, the work surface, or any other parameter. Okay, so when we change any of the machining operations, it automatically recalculates the toolpath for us. So that's the toolpath there that we've created for that simple profiling operation. So moving on from there, supposing now we needed to machine the fillet radius at the top of this shape. So what I'll do first of all is I'll just switch off this profiling operation so that because we don't need to see that. Okay, so that's just switched that off. Right, so what we need to do is we need to isolate the parts of the shape that we need to machine. So what we need to do here is we need to create another sketch, which is this base sketch, which you can see is shown through the model, and we need to offset that so it becomes the boundary for the outside shape. So to do that, it's sketch number 7, so if we right click that and we say copy parallel, so this will create another instance of that sketch. Okay, so that now becomes a sketch which I can use as a boundary. Now what I need to do is create another sketch of this top face. So if I highlight that, make a sketch from the face, so I've now got another sketch there which represents the smallest size that I want to machine. So when I come to machine those, I need to combine those two sketches. So if I highlight this sketch here, then hold down the control key and select that sketch, right click the mouse and say combine sketches. So what that will do is that's now created a sketch which in effect is the combination of two sketches. I can now use that as the outside and inside for my machining operation to machine the fillets around the top edge. Now what I could do of course is just use a simple profiling operation and an inverted radius cutter to do that, but I'll assume that I don't have one of those and I'm going to use just a standard ball nose. So let me set up that tool. So it's going to be a ball nose end mill and let's say it's 10 diameter. Okay, so that's that tool there, which looks about right. Okay, so I'm going to do a machining operation on that combined sketch, and I want to have that operation based on a surface. So I need to create a surface. So from the milling toolbar, I choose surface, and then that just creates a surface of that solid model. Now I can create a pocketing operation. I can set my step over. I'll set a large step over to start with, and I'll choose the tool I'm going to use, which is my ball nose end mill. I'm going to be basing this on a surface, and I'll make the step down 0, the final depth will be -5, and the sketch will be sketch number 8. Okay, so that's now calculating that toolpath based on the outside shape and the inside shape. So you can see how that's draped that toolpath over that shape. Now if I go back and modify that, I might want a smaller step over. So that's using the pocketing command, which is creating a toolpath over the shape using the outside and the inside sketches as its start and end point. You can see that because the outside sketch is slightly bigger than what I wanted, it's actually running off the part and running on at the same time. So that's created that toolpath for that. Now again, we could go back and we can change the step over to a smaller amount, so if we needed to rough this out with one tool and then finish it with another, we could simply copy and paste the pocketing operation and apply a different tool to that operation. Okay, so that's calculating that now, and you can see the results of that filleted toolpath.